how to create a character. Hi, it's Emily from Teacher's Pet and welcome to our first storytelling resource on how to create a character. Today we're going to be exploring 6 questions. Who is your character? What are the characteristics of your character? What does your character look like? What is your character's name? Imagine your character has a backpack. What would they carry in it? Character profile, and then a little sneaky extended task at the end. Who is your character? Characters play an important role in storytelling. They can take any form, from an object to a person. Animal characters are great in storytelling. Think of them as people in disguise. So today we're going to be focusing on an animal character. To begin, we need to pick an animal to base our character on. Let's have a look. Hippo! Now that you've chosen your animal, start to think about what they are like. What do they look like? Are they quite small? Are they quite big? What's their personality? Start asking yourself these questions early on. So when I think of a hippo, I think quite big, they're quite strong, but a little bit angry sometimes. But also, they're always on all fours. But it can be quite nice for characters to put them on 2 feet, just like people, which makes them more relatable. So here he is. Hello. What characteristics does your character have? The characteristics we choose often define who our character is. I want you to pick 2 adjectives that people would usually think of when they see your chosen animal. But it can sometimes be fun to pick characteristics that you wouldn't usually expect. Here's a few examples. So here we have a friendly hippo, a frantic hippo, and an enthusiastic hippo. So now it's time for me to pick the characteristics I want for my hippo character. Let's have a look. Elegant. So here we have an elegant hippo. Let's have a look for our second adjective. Proud. So here we have a very proud hippo. So now that we have our 2 adjectives, it's time to think about what would they be like together. So we have proud and we have elegant. Let's have a look. Here we have a proud, elegant hippo. Doesn't he look great? Now that you have your characteristics, it's time to ask yourself a few questions. So I could ask myself, why is my hippo elegant? Why is he proud? What does this tell me about my character? And what potential story could they have? What does your character look like? The appearance of your character can help support their characteristics. Now I want you to pick 2 adjectives that describe your character's appearance. Remember, it can be fun to pick adjectives that you wouldn't usually think of when you see your character. Let's look at a couple of examples. So here we have a tiny hippo. And a gigantic hippo. He's quite scary. And a really fluffy, cuddly hippo. Now we've looked at a few examples, time for me to think about what I want my character's appearance to be. So let's have a look at the first adjective. Clean. So let's clean up our hippo, shall we? So here we have a clean hippo. Now let's pick the second adjective. Sparkly. So here we have a very glamorous, sparkly hippo. So now that we have our 2 adjectives, time to think about them together. So we have clean and we have sparkly. Let's take a look. So here we have a clean, sparkly hippo. Doesn't he look amazing? So here's the fun part. Now it's time to pick the colour for our character. Remember to have fun. Your character could be any colour, from green to pink and to yellow. So now it's time for me to pick the colour I want my hippo to be. Purple. Oh, he seems to like that colour. So now that you have chosen your colour, I'd like you to think of a simile that would help describe the colour of your character. For example, my hippo is as purple as a royal gown. Now it's time to pick your character's accessories. Think about objects that will add to your character and their story. Let's have a look at a few examples. So here we have my hippo with some headphones on, listening to some music. I wonder what he's listening to. You know. And here we have him in a cape, like a superhero. I wonder what his superpower could be. And finally, we have him with a crown on. He must be royal or some sort of king. I wonder what he conquers. So now it's time for me to pick the accessory I want for my character. Let's have a look. Gloves. Now I've chosen gloves because I'm thinking my character doesn't like mud. He doesn't like to get dirty. So he needs to protect his feet from the ground. If it adds to your character's story, you can also pick another accessory. So I've picked a cape. I picked a cape so he looks like he's super clean, it's his superpower, and it gives me more of an idea of what his story could be. So here is our super clean hippo. What is your character's name? It's time to think about your character's name. Using the characteristic and appearance adjectives you have selected, think about what they could be called. Remember to keep it memorable and catchy, and have some fun. Let's have a think. So my character's a hippo. He's clean, so it could be a clean hippo. But he's also sparkly. Could it be a sparkly hippo? Clean, sparkly hippo? No, let's go with a clean hippo. Okay. His characteristics, he's proud. He's elegant. So could it be a proud, clean hippo? Proud, elegant hippo? I feel like there's something else there. There's something else we could do. What's my character's accessories? So let's have a think. His accessories are a cape. We're thinking he could be superhero based. So what about super clean hippo? That sounds good. We'll go with that. What have you come up with? Imagine your character has a backpack. What would they carry in it? Imagine your character has a backpack. What would they carry in it? I want you to pick four objects your character needs on a daily basis. Here's an example. So here is my hippo's backpack. The first object is hand sanitizer. My character needs hand sanitizer so he's always clean throughout the day. His next object is tissues. He needs tissues in case there's an accident, if there's a spillage, if he's got a little bit of mud on him, so he's always clean at all times. My character's third object is a book on germs. This is so he knows how to tackle every germ, every occasion. And his fourth and final object is a mirror. This mirror is because my character, he needs to check up on his appearance. He needs to see what he looks like throughout the day and make sure he always looks immaculate. Character profile. Now that we have built our character, it's time to bring them to life. Using the character profile sheet provided, draw your character, fill in their name and their characteristics. Here is mine here. And there we have it. Using these six simple questions, you have created your own character for your own story. Give your character a friend. An extended task. It's time for you to create a friend for your character. It can be fun to pick a character that contrasts with your original character. This can be in characteristics and appearance. So here's my friend. I've chosen a dung beetle on a very big ball of poo. Instantly, I've got a story here. I've got a really clean, immaculate hippo, and his friend is a beetle that's obsessed with dirt. I can start to think about what their relationship could be and who they are together. I can see conflict between the hippo and the dung beetle. Now I want you to pick a character for yourself. Go through the course again, but using a different focus, which can help you create a base for a great story. Thank you for joining this storytime lesson on how to create a character. I hope you have come up with some exciting new characters. See you next time.